1. And we are live, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to ACG, where we're just a couple gamers. It's your boy Smooth.
It's your boy Doc.
Rex.
Trying to steal your thunder. I just felt like you needed a bit of an introduction, Frigg. You are just not your average player. But guys, I do want to say that Sterling couldn't make it tonight. Just kidding. Of course Sterling is in the building. Ladies and gentlemen, Sterling.
There we go.
Guys, I don't know what it is about this song, but every time I hear it now, I'm going to think of Sterling. So, it's never going to get old to me.
Home of the Sterling. Not at all.
So today, ladies and gentlemen, we have the table talk. And this is something, it kind of just happened out of nowhere. We got all of us together a time or two, and it just felt right. So from now on, Sundays are table talk days. And we're going to talk about them, whatever the hell we want to, right? Because usually we have a topic, and we're I think, decently organized. We're working on getting more organized. But I do like the notion of a table talk. So while I do my thing, I'm going to let Doc do his thing, and then we'll get right into it.
What's happening, everybody? Long time no see. I've been away for a couple days. I had to take a mental break. I had to take a mental reset. I do want to announce today to everybody, okay? I am retiring from the game. I'm retiring from the game. But here's what I am going to do for you guys. If you guys notice, I've always mentioned for the past 54 episodes that we need moderators in other zones. And for the past 54 episodes, nobody has came up, right? Well, guess what? I'm going to be that guy. So starting tomorrow, okay, moving forward, Doc will be putting a camera in each zone in 29, starting from 29-1 to 29-6. Doc will be going in, and for right now, and if you guys have any suggestions, I'm going to put a data sheet, okay, courtesy of Frigg's idea. I'm just going to utilize that idea, Frigg. I'm going to piggyback on it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a data sheet together, and I'm going to put power rankings together, power mansions, family rankings together, top three in events in each zone. And I'm going to do my due diligence to do what we've been requesting others to do for us. Instead of me playing the game, I'm going to become part of the game and sharing information to you guys here on the podcast. Because before I was just doing one zone, and that's not fair to nobody. And so there was a situation that happened that just said, you know what, there's my door opening, right? Sometimes a negative always turns into a positive. Understand that. And I think just the knowledge that I've learned in these podcasts from, you know, Sterling, from Frigg, from T-Rex, from others just talking, I think I'd be better suited to anyone that's willing to assist, okay, that wants to help me out in gathering information for me in a zone. Believe me, I'm going to reach out and touch to all these new zones, okay? If it's you, let me know, okay? Let me know. And we can start putting a team together so when we do have these podcasts and these events and things like that, we can announce them in real time and we can give the people what they want. So with that being said, guys, it was a pleasure playing with every one of you guys. Definitely a pleasure. Now it's going to be a pleasure being a part of the community more and being more in tune. Back to you there, Chuck.
And as always, Doc, with a heavy heart, I would like to say thank you. I really appreciate that. And I appreciate the entire cast, guys. We have the entire cast in the house tonight. This is turning into a thing, guys, a thing that I very much like a lot. And so, you know, as I do think it is going to be a little saddening not being able to do events with Doc and whatnot. It'll be nice to actually have him announcing the event. So Godfather News Network, guys, is going to have a brand new dish of information for you. So the thing that you and Sterling were working on, Frigg, did you guys want to talk about that a little bit, or do you want to keep that on the DL for now?
It's not ready yet.
Yeah, sure. Got you. Yeah, so I can tell you guys, I'm not allowed to say what it is, but I can tell you that Sterling and Frigg are cooking up something for you guys. I'm not gonna say anything. Let me just change the subject because I can't say anything.
Right. Let's just move on because I guarantee you. I'm excited. There, you're gonna say something.
Yeah, I'm excited.
So let's talk about something. How's your day going? How about that? Let's just start something fresh and let's because we don't want to spoil that, dog.
Keep
that to yourself.
Sterling, how was your day?
Very uneventful. Had a nice family lunch, some pork tenderloin, some vegetables. Yeah, it was really chill. Very nice.
That sounds good.
That's what's up. That's
what about you, T-Rex?
It does.
Let's see. I spend most of the day cleaning and buying new appliances for the kitchen.
Damn.
Ooh, what'd you get?
Refrigerator, a new range or stove, oven, whatever part of the country you want to call it, and a new dishwasher.
Nice. Hell yeah. Them dishes gonna come out smelling lime.
that's a great combo.
I'm poor. The wife said we gotta go get my dishwasher broke. I spent all Friday trying to fix it. And the part that I need to replace was $200-something, and a new dishwasher is not much more than that. So I said, fuck that noise. And I made the mistake of taking the wife. We now have three brand new appliances.
Yeah, you gotta leave the wife at home when you go out to do those kinds of things. But you set yourself up for failure right there, my man. So, Frigg, you I asked you earlier. You said today
you went to the outlet.
Say what? What'd you say, bro?
She was at the outlets and you saw my can you not hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
And she saw my DS going to Lowe's and she ambushed me.
Sometimes it's like that, my man. You gotta hide in between two big vehicles, you know what I'm saying? Frigg, you said that your day was going pretty good. When I asked you earlier, everything's still going okay? Everybody's day's all right?
Yeah, it's all good. My youngest had a date with his girlfriend. I got to play chauffeur.
Oh, interesting.
And now he's out with his guy friends doing wiffle ball and basketball and all the little things that boys do. So
nice.
Other than that, it's been good.
If you guys in Chat Mafia are seeing any lags right now, can you please let me know?
Definitely lag.
Wow.
Yeah.
That lag was serious.
You're like breaking in and out.
Right.
I can hear you guys perfect now.
Cool. I think it's kind of funny when you come back in though, your speech gets real fast, like it's trying to catch up.
Right.
Okay. It seems like the lag is gone. Say what?
That's how you sound.
like the old micro machine. The old micro machine. Right. Guy, you know, one's talking fast. thank you very much for coming in.
I hope it's all caught up. Now. I hope it's all caught up.
Yeah, it should be.
Okay. So,
This is a lot better.
We've established that all of you have had a pretty decent day. I had to go to Hell's Kitchen today, and my day was absolute dog water. But I am very, very glad to be here with you guys tonight and to be doing this. I look forward to this all damn day. And also, guys, just a little sidebar note. With Frigg and Lethal on my back like spider monkeys, I have successfully learned how to use a shared calendar. Can we get a round of applause for the men out there who have learned how to use a shared calendar?
Thank goodness for Lethal, hey. That's all I gotta say.
That's a dollar in the noob jar. A dollar in the noob jar. That there was supposed to keep confidential.
What'd you say, Steve?
You would be struggling pretty hard without the woman in your life there, Smooth.
Yeah, I said thank God for the women making us guys better.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Let me give
improving our lives.
Let me give you living
Amen.
Proof.
Amen.
Let me give you living proof on that, okay? When before I met Lethal, I had patches, literal patches of hair falling out of my head. Right?
No and, way.
Dude, I swear. Like I would just wake up and I would have like nickel, dime, and quarter, all different size coin shaped spots in my head. And for a long time, I was convinced I had alopecia or however you say it. It's like the disorder where like you lose hair. You have fucking you. There's nothing really much you can do about it. So I was convinced because, again, I was younger. I'm like, there's no way I'm just losing hair naturally. This has got to be something, right? I meet her within a couple months. She's visiting me all the time and stuff, and she's bringing like these bottles of vitamins and stuff. So she would take it, got into be like a habit when she would come stay the night with me. You know, she'd wake up, take vitamins, and she'd give me some. No shit. I started taking the vitamins myself because I got into the habit of it. All different kinds of vitamins, right? My hair just started naturally growing back. Ain't that some shit?
I believe it.
Girl, women are godsends. I shit you not, women are godsends. Shout women out Misha are Mack. Nurturers. Shout out Livia.
That's why.
Say what?
I said women are nurturers. That's why when you have a good woman around you, the man becomes successful in anything that he does because that woman, that strong woman, is helped nurturing what he has provided. And that's why you went from there to there. Facts. So, shout out to all the women in the world.
She might have been slipping you some Rogaine without you knowing.
I don't know that, too. Right. Probably spraying that shit while you was in a coma that's sleeping so after you ate.
Smooth sleeping. She's in the bathroom replacing the shampoo with nothing but Rogaine.
Right.
There you go.
Bro, that's messed up, dog. Like, that is messed up.
She's like, he's cute.
Rogaine in a pill form. She said, I can't walk around with diamond patches. No, can't walk around with diamond patches.
Bro, like,
can't do it.
Look, right? Look, before I met her, I was so self-conscious about my damn head, bro. Like, I went from having no hats to mo hats, and I had a hat for every outfit, every color, right? I met her. It was the first time in a long time. Like, I didn't feel like I needed to wear a hat. I was like, man, this shit is crazy. I thought I was going to be bald within a year. Crazy. Apparently, I just wasn't taking care of myself, and I needed the vitamins and all that shit. So, glad we got that squared away. Say what?
I said, who would have guessed?
Who would have guessed, man?
Yeah. Right. Who would have guessed?
Who would have?
I'm going to have to message Lethal and ask what vitamins she was giving you.
Vitamin. Hey, yeah. Vitamin Rogaine. She got it in the capsule.
Vitamin
H. Pretty good.
Okay, guys. Okay. So, we need to kind of come up with some questions for each other. We can have Chat Mafia, you know, fire some questions away. Shout out because we have a lot of people in here actually. Really appreciate you guys for watching. If you guys have any questions at all game related to the round table for of you know the table of co-hosts here, guys, if you guys have any questions for them, That would be nice to hear it. And then also, guys, I do want to say that with all of the co-hosts that we've accumulated now, this is a team now. I do feel like we do need some more moderators because we're kind of taking on more and more work as this goes on. You know, I'm always working on two or three things at one time. Frigg went from being a Discord moderator for the official Godfather Discord to writing up spreadsheets for KCL and FCL. And now she's taken on a bunch of responsibilities for the podcast. And then, you know, trying to keep people with full-time jobs and stuff, doing stuff. Doc is doing stuff like Sterling and T-Rex. It's crazy, guys. So if we could get just a couple moderators from our chat mafia to kind of help us out and, you know, keep the workload down a little bit so we can keep this content rolling out for you guys, that would be great. So feel free to contact us. You guys, I have my official Discord for my Discord in the Chat Mafia. Just click that link, guys. And if you guys are interested in a moderator position, just holler at one of us in the Chat Mafia chat. Okay, so as far as questions go, I feel like I'm always the one asking the questions, all right? I feel like Tucker Carlson sometimes. So if you guys have any questions for me, tonight's the night to ask, okay? Tonight's the night to ask.
Does that mean that me and Frank can leave our tap shoes up in the closet tonight?
I mean, I promise I will not shoot at your feet tonight, all right?
Be careful what you promise, because sometimes things get said you just stepped into it.
It does, and it happens indirectly, and that's what pisses me off so much. I try so hard. Like, I feel like I've gotten pretty damn good at this over, you know, the last year or so, and especially since we started doing these podcasts. So it's always funny to me when I mess up. Like, I don't even get hard on myself anymore. I just laugh at myself. I'm like, how? How after all this time?
all of last week I'd hang up and I'm like, yep, he wants me to zero him. I know it.
Yeah. One more thing. I feel like I have to say this.
Oh boy.
To the people who followed me from server to server, and to the people who joined 29-1 just to be with me because you guys supported the podcast, and just to everybody that I was with in 29-1 for so long, I want to apologize personally for having to move families so much. And I know it's a headache, and I feel bad. I feel very bad. But I just want to say it's completely out of my control. So I just want to say that. I do feel bad. I know you guys are dedicated to the show. I know you guys are loyal to me. And so thank you for that. And yeah, just had to say that. So who is Canuck? Anybody know?
Is that Ruckus?
It's Canuck. Canuck, who are you? Who goes there?
If she's in there with Olivia, that's got to be Ruck.
Yeah, let me say something nicely. Hi, Canuck. How are you doing?
Right there.
If you can, share us your name. Don't listen to what Smooth said. He's just so aggressive. I'm just coming at you. You know, that welcoming was garbage. Okay, so I don't want you to feel. Yeah, you're. It's cool. It's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucker's acting like Trump right now because he has the blue vest on. Don't let that fool you, goddammit. Looking like baby Trump over there with the MAGA cap. Come on now. Goddammit.
Usually people get a round of applause when they come in, but if you know,
who are you? What is your name? What's going on?
Hold on a second. Who the hell
who
is
you, eh?
Who the hell's Todd?
Hey, who's
who
Todd?
The fuck is Todd?
Who's Todd?
Who's Todd?
Who's Todd? Don't tell me. No. Don't tell me Todd is who I think Todd is.
Is that Todd Rex?
No way.
Do we have Todd Rex on the phone?
No way, Todd. Todd the T-Rex.
Is that Todd Rex?
T-Rex's name is not Todd.
Okay. Good. All right, good.
There's a story good. That goes
good. Good. That's not that. I hope that's not your middle name either, though. Because
No. These crazy Canadian bitches don't let this shit go.
Bro. Oh, that shit is
Todd. Hey, okay. First question. Here we go. First question of the night. There it is. Who is Uncle Todd, though? Sorry, that's the first question. I had to do it.
I don't even remember 100% how that name came to be. But I think we were on maybe server 23, and I was dicking around in World Chat messing with somebody. And he was just like, oh, yeah, blah, 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 blah. The guy's name was, you know, like something basic like Todd. So I was like, I just changed my name to Todd and started fucking with him. And then two crazy Canadian chicks that I used to hang out with, they started calling me Uncle Todd, and that shit is just never, well, it never went any further than them, but it's never died.
Uh-oh, I got a new name. Uncle Todd. Uncle Todd to the show, ladies and gentlemen.
I just like Todd Rex. Let's go. Instead of T-Rex, I like Todd Rex.
Todd Rex.
Todd Rex? That sounds like a vitamin that you took for your hair.
What the fuck, bro? Look, I knew I shouldn't have said anything about it. I knew
bro,
it.
Bro, you opened that door, I dog. Yeah, hey, I told you, look. I needed that 2 days of mental rest and that tranquility because I feel like Ace Ventura right now. So I'm going to slap jokes on anybody right now.
Now all I can see is Doc. I can't remember what Ace Ventura it was when he's up climbing the mountain and he's up there with the monks.
Oh, yeah.
Remember he's up there with the monks?
Yes. I was in my yoga. Yes. All righty I swear to God, that's me, dude. That was me all day. Swear to God, smoking blunts and just laughing.
I was just gonna say, surrounded by a cloud of weed smoke.
I was, definitely was, and I had my smoke partner Cleo, and we were great. We were great.
Doc brought us all clouds to the mountaintop.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
I have
sir.
A serious question. This is for both Sterling and Frigg. Do you think, this is a two-part question. Do you think, well, I guess I have to ask the other question first. What type of events, if at all, tournaments could you host in older servers? That's the first question. And the second question is, if you can, if there would be any style at all tournaments to do for fun, what would they be?
I don't know about your question, but like it's bugging the hell out of me. You haven't killed that invasion boss yet. You need to kill that shit.
Disregard your question. And go kill the boss.
Listen.
I love when Sterling just watches the screen.
Don't kill it. Let it sit there and let your family members kill it.
That's what I was waiting for. That's what I was waiting for.
Join the podcast family and let me kill that shit.
That is hilarious. He said, disregard the question. You need to go kill that boss, guy.
It's been bugging me for the last 5 minutes. I'm like, you're not even trying to kill it right now. Like, you're not getting anything from it. Just
Because every time I try to kill it, I can never kill the fucking thing. And I get it almost dead. I run out of that energy shit. And then somebody from my family kills it. This happened to me 4 times already.
Yeah, but every time that you hit that, though, you get rewards for it. Like, that's the thing, right. Though. If you have, like, this is where the spenders have the... Oh, my God, we're getting so off topic.
There's no topic.
I guess, technically.
It was a question.
Every time that you hit that, you get rewards. So, like, We have people that will do like a hit with five troops and just like keep getting rewards all the way through. But then, of course, there's some dickhead that comes through and doesn't know any better
and
kills the whole thing. But
that's where everybody
gets pissed off. But you got to take your hits while you got them.
Oh my God,
that's me. I'm the dickhead.
Hold on a second. You just broke my brain.
Dickhead Uncle Todd.
Only in the last 30 minutes.
You know what? You know what, T-Lex? You're the reason why I've been getting complaints. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, you know what, Frig? Just get ready for it in 18. It's fucking coming, all right?
Hold on a second.
I'll tell you what. You steal any of my bosses, I'm going to come and hunt you down.
Can we go back a second?
I won't be hard to find. I'll be the one killing everyone's boss.
Guys.
But seriously, I only do it in the last 30 minutes if the player is not online. Because I'd rather not waste it. So that's my philosophy.
I have a real question. Seriously.
Wait, I thought we were asking you questions.
Yeah, but you got to answer my original question. You can't answer a question with a question.
You have to. Get your tap shoes on, Frig. Here it comes.
Listen, serious question. The question is about the event, okay? Sterling just said something that had me like WTF, okay? He said, if you hit it with like a couple troops, you'll keep getting rewards. Does it not give you rewards based off the amount of damage you do?
No.
Oh my God. So I can just do it over and over with just a couple troops?
Until you run out of the energy. But if this is one of those events, like, you can really, really rack up some rewards if you spend a few dollars on. Like, we had one event where, or one episode, we talked about that. But, like, if you have a lot of energy saved up, like, you can rack up a lot of rewards in that event. But you have to have a family that respects the rule where you only hit with a handful of troops.
Sterling, what if you're the only person in your family?
Well, then you're fucked either way, so.
What if you're the only person? Hey, speaking of which,
I've been killing my whole family's boss the whole event so far.
Bro, I just joined over there. You better not kill my boss.
Oh, did you? Okay, I'm coming.
Fucking do it.
Have at it.
But you also can, if I'm not mistaken and remember correctly, you can also get rewards if somebody else kills your boss.
They're just not a lot. It's basically the same as one or less.
Okay. Yes.
You do get like a little mail that tells you that someone else killed your boss and it gives you rewards for it.
But it's not going to tell you who, so you don't know who to be mad at.
Speaking of which, let's just go ahead and cover this topic while we're already on it.
It was me.
You have the microphone.
You want to go ahead and cover the event?
Okay, I'm trying to do this without getting aggravated. Let me preface this. Anybody who thinks outside of this group and outside of my immediate family, anybody who thinks that they know where I stand on this event does not know. You are presuming to know something that you know absolutely nothing about. So, with that said, I do not steal anybody's boss. except for the ones associated with my farms. And by all means, I'm going to steal those bitches all the time.
Well, they're mine anyway.
That's hilarious.
Boss stealer.
That's hilarious.
So, with that said, this comes up every single time this event comes up. Every single time somebody complains about somebody else stealing their boss.
I can hear you slamming the desk with your fist right now.
It's my ottoman. I'm trying to talk without being aggravated. Every single time people complain about other people stealing their boss and they want an email to tell them who stole their boss? Right. Okay, so my right. question to you is, what are you going to do with that information? It doesn't solve the problem. Knowing who stole your boss does not solve the problem. It does one of two things. Okay. If it is the spender, the top spender in your family, the M37 in your server, who is stealing the boss, what are you going to do? Go and burn them?
Nothing.
No, you're not going to do shit. If it is some M21 who needs the rewards in order to be able to grow faster, are you going to say something to them? Are you going to burn them? Knowing who stole your boss is nothing but a bully tactic, and that is my stance. Period.
There it is.
That is my stance. It is a bully tactic. Period. If you were upset that someone stole your boss, then find a way to constructively come up with a suggestion about this event to make it better. And one of the things that I heard the other day was, it's too easy. Make it harder. It's supposed to be a family-oriented event when the oranges are shared so that the family can help you kill them. So make the oranges harder. So, okay, yes, that is a great idea. And you know what? I passed that along to the devs. But coming at me saying, I need to know who killed my boss is nothing but a bully tactic. And that is my stance.
I'm sorry. I tried not to laugh, but she said, coming at me?
Right. Oh, hey, round of applause for Frigg right there.
Round of applause for Frigg. Let's go.
She let it out. She bent it. She let it out.
Let's go. We need that. Hey,
I hate to say it, but this event makes me very passionate, and I have very strong feelings about it because every time it comes up, I hear about it from everybody, from Discord, from private messages, from my own family, and it is such wildly opposite opinions.
Yeah, but
why'd you take my ball?
Yeah, but don't you know, Frigg? You can just wave your magic wand and make it happen.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Wave my wand. Right. Let me go find it. Where's Tinkerbell?
Right.
And our cast.
The sad part is, I think we probably all know people that would be like, fuck it, I will zero them if they take my boss.
Oh, 100%.
Absolutely. And that's the reason why that name never needs to come out, because there are people on every server that if somebody stole their boss, they're going to drop tags and go and zero them.
That's crazy.
I'm not going to contribute to bullying behavior, because that shit happens all the time, regardless of the devs giving somebody a name.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I agree. 100%.
Yep.
Your family. You're supposed to be family.
Absolutely.
You're all in it together.
Absolutely.
All the same cause. Family.
We're happy.
Can I tell you guys something funny?
Yeah.
All right.
It's a very interesting concept, getting mad at people over something that you don't actually know anything about.
That's crazy. Like control over.
That's ironic, isn't it? It's so ironic. That is an ironic piece right there.
Because, you know, the information's not out there, but it's kind of like, if you don't watch a TV show, how could you know if you like it or not? Because you've never seen it.
Okay, ding.
Let me tell y'all something funny that happened to me in real life, okay? So, we get this, we get new management where I work, okay? The guy at the top, he's brand new.
Did you vote on it, or was he hired?
No, he was hired. Yeah, he was hired.
Okay.
So
you know, it was maybe like someone didn't win the vote and they got mad and they decided to leave the country club or something. Yeah.
so
we got go across the street to the other country club and just sit there and wait while the other country club is just waiting on what he's about to do.
Yeah.
Is that what that is?
The sister country club.
Yeah. So, In that same county.
Look, this is the most comedic, I don't even know the word for it. It's just the most comedy I've ever seen.
Comedic.
Comedic. There you go.
The most comedic shit
I've ever seen in my life. So they get this new food and beverage guy. Okay, he's basically at the top, and then they get this new guy who's supposed to be a kitchen manager, who's above me.
Wait. Right? So you have So you have two people already.
Yeah.
Okay. So you have A and you have S. Got you. Go ahead. Keep going.
Right. Okay. So they hire these people. The guy at the top, the food and beverage manager. I wasn't at work a few days ago. When I came in the next day, well, okay, keep in mind, I wasn't supposed to be there till 9. I called him at 5 or 6 in the morning just to let him know, hey, I'm not coming. Uh-huh. Okay. He very next day when I come in, he comes in and he goes, hey, if you're not going to be here, you need to let me know. I'm like, I called you at like 5 in the morning and left a voicemail. He's like, are you sure? He checks it and goes, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm like, all right, dick. Right. So then it happens again, but with this other new guy. So I wasn't there the other day. He comes in. He says, hey, man, I'm not trying to get on you or nothing. Just if you're not going to be here, can you let me know? I said, I gave you my number last week. You never texted me to make sure I had yours.
That's crazy,
bro. I'm like, this is who I'm working for. This is what it's come to.
That reminds me of the office with the TPS reports. Like five managers stop by the guy's.
Oh my god! Don't get me started.
Yeah, we're gonna need those TPS reports,
bro. I swear, man, there's no good management anymore. They, you know, management used to say, oh, you can't find good employees. And now it's the other way around. Employees are like, man, we can't find good management.
Yeah, no, you're definitely true. Because, you know, these companies nowadays, they do stupid shit. Like, oh, you know, I'm not going to put my company in out there, but my company does dumb shit. Like, you know, we're in the transportation industry. And we move people from one place to another, but, you know, not in the air. So we go out and we're like, oh, our CEO sucks. So we're going to fire him. Let's hire a CEO from a airline that is failing. So, like, you know, I think, what was it, U.S. or American Airlines and Continental just merged. One of them bought out the other one. And my company was like, oh. The guy that was, you know, that lost his job in that merger because he didn't do a good job, let's hire him and let him run the show. Brilliant. The guy has zero idea what we do whatsoever, but he's going to come in and make wholesale changes across the board to everything we do. It's amazing.
Yep. That's literally what
happened. How's that working out?
I think it's working out really well for him because I think he made like $500,000 last year, and his bonus was like $600,000.
So he's over 1.1. He's good.
Yeah, you know, when your bonus is more than your base salary, and the company's in the red,
something's good.
Yeah.
You know. Can I remind everybody we're supposed to be asking smooth questions right now?
Oh, shit.
Right.
Oh, damn. Okay. Okay. All right, I'll play this game.
Hey, you started.
Today, guys, you asked me questions.
What's up?
You're going to ask me questions. So, by the way,
Charlie, I got two phone questions for you.
Oh, for me? Okay.
No, that was you. No, that was smooth. Him telling us to ask him.
Oh yeah,
I actually did have one kind of not so serious question that I don't expect him to answer and just completely ignore, and then I have another one. Actually, I'm more interested in what is the smartest thing you've done in game? What is the dumbest thing that Lethal has done in game?
What is the smartest thing I've done in game?
Yeah.
Right.
The smartest thing I ever did in this game. Start this podcast. Start this podcast. Easy. Easy answer. This was the easiest answer for sure. The dumbest thing. Oh, see now. Okay, I see what you just did there, Sterling. I see what you just did there. He just made me dance. You made me put my tap shoes on, you son of a bitch. You son of a bitch.
Right.
I see what you just did there, and I almost answered it.
That was good. God, that was good. And if you would have answered it, you'd have been in the doghouse, player.
With her in the chat.
Over.
With,
it would have been,
you know,
over.
You know, I actually think that that is a really good pair of questions, but instead of asking what's the dumbest thing Lethal's done, you should answer what's the dumbest thing you've done.
Easy.
So what's the smartest thing you've done, and what's the dumbest thing you've done?
Dumbest.
And that's for everybody.
Same answer. And start doing the podcast.
Okay. Whoa. I got you. Okay. Here you go. This is a two-part answer because I still kick myself in the ass for the old thing I did. But do you guys remember?
I can't remember. Sorry. My bad.
I can't remember what episode it was.
My bad.
But we were talking about how when you equip gear on your capos, you're not supposed to do it every time. You're not supposed to put stars with gold and screws and shit on your equipment every time you do it, right? Like, people think that if you put the gold, I mean, you are supposed to do it, but only when you have your capos at a level where you're gonna utilize them more, you know what I'm saying, for fighting and shit like that, right? Or maybe just to get stronger so you can accomplish an event. But players, including myself, I thought every time you switch color or go to the next level of capo color or whatever, you're supposed to put screws and gold into all those items. And I was told that when you do that, all of those stats carry on. So you would level, you'd star up all your capo gear that's equipped, and then you go to the next color, and then all of those stats would save, and then you do it again to the next color, and then you go to the next one, and then all those stats would stack. That's what I was told. And then come to find out, after a couple servers of doing this and wasting tons and tons of gold and screws, I was informed that's not the case. So if you're listening to this, don't do that. Don't do that. Okay? So that's the first dumb thing I did. Who knows how much gold, probably in the hundreds of thousands of gold and the tens of thousands of screws. Easily. Okay, down the drain. The other thing that I did, which was not that long ago, so putting $5 in the noob jar, I used 70 hobby items on capos that were... I can't even finish my sentence. I wasted 70 capo hobby items. Yep, sure did. I did that. Yep. And what makes it worse is,
well,
I had
who was it that you upgraded?
You really want to go there?
Well, one wasn't that bad, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, this I really is, want to go there because I'm sure we all have experiences ass like move this. Day.
This is ass move day.
Who did you upgrade?
You did for plenty of ads.
Okay, so Fabrizio, Carlo, and there was another one that I wasted them all on. I guess Fabrizio's Nicholas. Not bad. Carlo's good Nicholas. if you want the extra coordination. But outside of that, there was another McCluskey. One that I wasted it on.
McCluskey.
I don't know if I would consider that a waste.
Yeah, well, I thought we mentioned that when we covered. I don't even remember what episode it was, but
yeah.
Fabrizio, like, for guns, is not, he's a good capo.
Okay,
I think that the thing is, he used them and he upgraded capos that weren't specific to the type of march that he wanted to do.
Yeah.
So,
right.
Yeah, so what I thought was.
Okay, but let me give you a hint, Smooth. You start with one troop type, and at some point, you have to add variety.
Yeah. Right. Gotta branch out.
Well,
spice.
You have to add a little spice. Little spice. Yes. So I do not consider this a bad thing. At least you didn't upgrade like Dwayne and Bernardo.
No, listen.
Your mouth.
If I would have wasted 70 hobby items or even if I would have wasted any hobby items on fucking Bernardo, we wouldn't be having this conversation because I would have quit the podcast.
I'm about to leave. I got like a 4-star Bernardo somewhere very early in my career.
Oh, but, my gosh.
Before I knew any better.
I should show you guys what somebody did to this account before I got it. I have a fairly heavily upgraded Dwayne on my hands.
Oh, yeah.
That was not my doing.
A fan of mine, no doubt.
Well, I've definitely seen it. I had a guy on one server, was a pretty decent spender, but he was new to the game, and he was showing me all of his stuff, and he was, you know, sent me a line, and the next thing I know, I was like, dude, I'm like, what are you doing on these capos? Yet it was like Dwayne and Bernardo was definitely pretty heavily starred up. I was like, oh my god, so much wasted money.
I will never do it. And like, that's the only thing that makes me mad. Is it's not even like that I wasted it. It was that I had access to all you guys. I had access to the information and I just didn't ask first. I was so excited. I was like, just opening everything, just using everything. And Regrets. Sad face.
Happens. It happens sometimes. Yep.
But not anymore.
The best thing Doc ever did was he let you do it.
That's what. Oh, that was a low
blow. Get your tap dancing shoes.
That was a low blow, bro. Because
I've been had mine on. Mine were tied up tight. I was just waiting on the door to open so I could come in and tap around.
Hey, shout out to Lethal for posting the link in multiple servers. She is posting it in multiple servers. We really appreciate you, Lethal. Thank you so much. So my account in 29.5, not trying to boast or anything, but my capos are official. Official is a whistle right now. I even unlocked the confusion skill already. I unlocked the distraction skill already. Basically all the purple skills, which I'm under the impression that these other ones I don't really need, so I'm just gonna break those down during the capo event. But yeah, I feel like my capos are tight now. I'm just working on my second force, and I'm excited to put these bad boys to use.
Yes.
Yep.
Everybody,
what do you guys do with all your screws? Like, when you get to your guys' level, what do you guys do with them?
Use them.
I put them in jars.
I put them in jars.
No, I seriously. I got a drawer next to the fridge.
No, seriously, because like that guy posted the picture of, the 10th, 60,000 skills or whatever. Like, what do you guys do with them? Seriously. You guys just save them up and you're waiting on a new capo to come out? Huh?
I think honestly, really the only person that's able to answer that question right now would probably be Sterling, because my capos aren't ready to be like completely maxed out. So I'm still holding on to my screws until they're maxed and then I'll use them.
Yeah, I mean, basically, like, I've got 34,500 ready to use, but...
You have 34,000 screws?
Dude, you have no idea how quickly those go when you get to the orange level.
34,000? Hold on a second. How many screws are we talking about? Wait, the amount of screws go up as you level your capo up?
Of course.
Yeah.
Oh, them sons of bitches.
Not just that. not just the screws, but it's the bank too. Like, that's the biggest thing. Bro. So once you get to orange level 4, just one single upgrade for the equipment is 200,000 bank.
No way.
Do you want proof?
200,000?
Bank is like mana from the gods.
Mana from the gods. That's really good. I like that. Okay. But no, seriously, friggin' Sterling. Before we end up getting out of here.
Friggin' Sterling.
What do you think tournaments would work in older servers? Like, let's just say in a dream world, we had 10 active players from an old server that just wanted to say, fuck it, let's just do an event. Do you think they would work like a gathering events and you know, just stuff like that? Do you think they would work for older servers?
I don't know. I think I would have to see how it works first to be able to answer that.
See how it works. When you see
a gathering event for the old servers, I mean, we still have gathering events. So, I mean, if you're talking about something that works across different zones, like, I'd have to see exactly how it was set up to be able to answer that.
So basically how I envision it is, let's just say, for instance, like I said, you had 10 players, doesn't matter if they're in a family or they're not, on go. It would be server specific. So it'd be on go. Everybody's ready. Whoever can gather the most amount of resources, hits count, which I highly doubt that would even happen in older. It'd be very boring without hits, but an event is an event, right? So, basically they would have to live stream, or, you know, some form of being able to show us so we can watch them, closely, and that would be it. It'd be just that simple. And then same thing with all the other events.
You can chime in.
Well, my thoughts are, again, this goes back to how older servers are just, we have advanced to the point where there's no one to hit. Like,
right.
You may have like a small handful, maybe less than 10, maybe even less than 5 trolls on your server. And most of them have learned at this point not to gather. So you're not hitting anybody. It is literally that boring during gathering event. You're just literally going out and gathering and then coming back.
Okay.
And the idea of having to fast gather is no longer there anymore because you're not competing against anybody else in your server. It's just you and your family.
See, but that's the thing. That right there might be the reason why it might be fun. Because even though you're in a family, if you're competing for the packs, the prizes, you are competing. You're competing amongst your own family members. Which, like I said, it doesn't matter if you're in a family or not. If anything, it's probably be even cooler to be able to, you know, try and have kind of rivalry with somebody that you've been playing with for so long. But would a neutral gangs event work?
I don't think so, Hunter.
No?
I think that comes down to whoever has the highest VIP.
Yeah.
I mean, once you get to a certain level, like, You have a certain amount that you can hit each day, and even when you get to, like, because your mansion 37 is going to have the highest amount of those. So if you have somebody that's an active mansion that's that high, like, if they do everything, then they win.
So it's more of a who does it first.
Like, we are at a point, Smooth, just so you understand, we are at a point now in our timeline on 18 where we are contemplating how to make Purge beneficial for people who aren't spenders. Because, you know, the same small group of spenders get on, they knock it out in like 3 hits and move on for the rest of the day. But those people don't need gold. You know, some of them have like millions in gold in their account and they're like, I don't need this. So we're like, the people that need the gold are the ones that need to be doing purge.
You said millions.
So it's not even about like how many points you get. Yeah, that's absolutely. True. If you spend a lot, yeah, absolutely. If you buy packs and you spend a lot, you're going to have millions of gold in your account that just sits there. Bruh. Ready to be used for war or whatever, or upgrades, whatever they need it for. But the point is those people don't need the benefits from getting first in the event.
Right, right.
It's the people who don't spend that need the benefits of getting first in the event. So we're trying to manipulate who plays events and who gets first so that they can get the gold that they need.
Which takes a lot of effort.
They're so bored on 18 that they invited me to come play with them. Like that.
Why do you guys say it like that? Why do you guys say it like that? Like, you got to be extremely bored or else we don't want to hang out with Rex.
Rick was like, we got nothing to do here. Fine, just bring him over. He'll bring comic relief. That they just love somebody to laugh funny. At.
You are going to be the server jester. Like, they're just going to throw
shit at you. We can always use a little spice on our server.
Yeah, that's. I'm going to put on a silly hat and put on my tap shoes. I'm going to come in and entertain Frigg and, you know, all the rest of the big mansions, and that'll be that.
Oh God. Okay, so, guys.
Yeah.
I do want to say that we are going to keep the drama separate from the show. So the show is this, right, guys? I think you guys have a basic understanding. Like, we try to keep it informal, informational. We try to keep things pretty organized and on topic for the most part, other than like the table talk, because then we can talk about whatever we want, and it feels free. But we are going to be doing a Like It or Not podcast. We did a couple episodes in the beginning, but I think that we're going to keep Like It or Not very loose. We're going to cover game topics as well as stuff that's going on in real life. We're going to keep it nice and loose on Like It or Not. But if you guys are missing the drama, if you guys are missing all that good shit, we're going to keep it separate from the show, but you guys can always find it in the ACG Discord. If you guys have not subscribed already, definitely join the ACG Discord. You can find it in the link right there in the live stream. And we'll be doing, Like It or Not, it's late night talks and stuff. So it'll definitely be interesting, something fun to watch. I do want to continue this conversation about the tournaments. And I do think that tournaments are going to be prudent. I think that all the newer servers doing tournaments there, I think, are going to be super exciting. I would like to come up with something for the older servers before these dinosaur players fall asleep and just don't wake up. I need personally to be able to have some type of eyeballs in these older servers, because I've been playing this game for so long that I would really, really like to be able to watch these guys. I mean, for fuck's sake, Sterling showed a picture the other day of his book right here, his book and all of his skill. He was able to use like all of them. It looked like a NASA button panel. Like, it was just all kinds of shit lit up. And he's like, yeah, you can use multiple of these. Bro, what the hell are you talking about? I can't imagine being able to just use all my talent skills. Just boom, 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 just pushing buttons. Like, I would love to. But unfortunately, I can't do that. So I would like to live vicariously through some of these dinosaur players. If you're a dinosaur and you've been playing this game a long time, message me, okay? Say something. Come out from Jurassic Park and give me ideas. If you can even think of one decently good idea for the older servers, I'll do it. I'll do it. I don't care. I'll get it done. I'll do it, guys. All right? So, like I said, I appreciate everybody for watching, guys. Thank you so much to all of my co-hosts. Thank you so much to all of our moderators and the ACG team. Thank you so much to the community. We love you guys. Is there anything you guys want to say to the people before we get out of here?
Um, uh, That's a loaded question. Yeah. Nope. Like, subscribe, you know. I ain't going nowhere, so
whatever. T-Rex will be here, y'all.
What you gotta do.
Yeah, I would say, just tying on top of that, like, we have some things that we're trying to work on to make everything more interesting for everybody. So part of that includes sending in any type of content that you have, any information you have, screenshots. So if you have anything you want to send in, send it to Smooth, Doc, myself, Frig, anybody. Anything you send in will absolutely help the content that we make.
Yeah, absolutely. Great point. Great point. Yeah, hey,
even if you want to come on,
I had
somebody reach out to me today and said, can you talk Smooth, because my boyfriend wants to come on. And I know the boyfriend is a good player. I've talked Smooth, and we're going to try to get him on. So, you know, doesn't hurt to ask.
Right. What are you saying, Frig?
Well, I have something to say. Yeah, but now that Xena is back on to the live chat, just kind of put a bug in everybody's ear. Sterling and I are working on something big behind the scenes that Smooth kind of alluded to earlier in the podcast. And we will need various servers / families input in on this, and it has to do with SCL. So please keep your eyes and ears open to the podcast and anything that's posted on Discord or the ACG Discord, because we will definitely be needing a lot of people's help in regards to what we're putting together.
Yeah, that's what I like to hear. Okay, so things are about to get really interesting for you guys. And thank you so much for doing that, by the way, because I do know what you're doing. And I know it's not going to be anything easy. Definitely going to need the help of a lot of people from different servers, I think, would probably be the best case. But I'm very excited for it. I'm excited for everything that we're about to be bringing you guys. It's a lot. It's a whole lot. What about you, Doc? Anything you want to say?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Like I said before in the beginning of the announcements, I'll reiterate it. I don't play the game no more, but I am going to be going to different zones in 29 and just keeping up with rankings and stuff and get a data sheet. Also, just on top of what Smooth said, for the Lion podcast, I recommend you come down and listen tomorrow night. Let's just say that. I just recommend that you come down, bring you some popcorn, bring you a 6-pack, a 12-pack, an 18-pack, whatever your heart desires, okay? If you want, bring you some bottle of wine. And then for your smokers, bring you a whole pack, okay? Because we're going to talk about a variety of things. But like Smooth mentioned, we're keeping the drama out of this podcast. And so to respect wishes, these last 2 days, I've been gathering information. I've been putting pieces of puzzles together. I've been putting timelines together. So everybody that thinks the storm is clear, come to the podcast tomorrow night. I'm naming names, and I'm letting everything out. All right? Love y'all. I love y'all. I love y'all to death. But like Spook said, this ain't the podcast. So we have another one. And I would love for you guys to come, because I'm going to tell you something. The truth is really not out there. The truth is sitting in my notebook right now. All right, y'all? Yes, sir.
So don't miss it, guys. Do not miss it. Tomorrow night, we're going to be shooting for probably around 10 o'clock EST. That's about, 7 o'clock? Your West Coast time.
Yeah,
you guys definitely do not want to miss that, and that's only going to be on Like It or Not. But until next